Hey folks, how's it going? Here we are with the WePlay Season 3 game, probably one of the last games to be played, but Team Empire going up against Power Rangers or PR. These are two fairly newish rosters now, I believe, so it'll be interesting to see how this plays off. It is, I believe, just a one game series, so just one match, best of one, however you want to call it. Looks like both teams had their full roster. I was just checking out their rosters, their new roster changes before... just before this game started, but it looks like, okay, Empire, looks like they've got everyone here at the moment. Although I thought they had Ramses, PR, they've got everyone as well. But, so, might as well just get straight into this draft. I should guess just the same, a lot of you probably don't know me. I am Zambrella, or as my Twitter alias or handle it is, Zambrella101. So straight into the draft, Team Empire, ban out the Nature's Prophet and the Chen. Whereas Power Rangers ban out the Earth Spirit and the OD. So both teams from the CIS region, I believe. Don't know if the meta's any different, but this is pretty standard stuff. The Chen ban is not entirely not something we see all the time, but it is definitely a strong hero. But this does allow for Team Empire to pick up the Invoker Faceless Void. Pretty decent combo, but PR, they go with the Enchantress. I think Enchantress pretty good against Faceless Void. Does have to watch out for the magic damage of the Invoker, but Beastmaster as well for PR. I think Beastmaster is probably top five strongest heroes of this patch. It's just so strong, the amount of vision you can give it can give you. You can even, like, if you get Necro 2, Necro 3, you can just solo up a carry. If Beastmaster can, you know, maybe a smoke up, even without an ally, just solo smoke up, get the Invoker, use the Roar with the Boar plus the Necro 3 can actually solo kill the Invoker pretty easily. As long as you do max out the Inner Beast for the extra attack speed. In terms of bans now. Oh, by the way, let me know if there's any issues with the stream or whatever. Hopefully it should be okay and the audio is all good. Woo! Should be good. In terms of bans now, we've gone through those actually pretty quickly. Team Empire banning out the Puck and the Venge, and Power Rangers banning out the Gyrocopter and Witch Doctor, understandably against the Faceless Void. Probably two of the best heroes to combat with the Faceless Void, of course. Witch Doctor nerfed it a little bit a while ago. Can't put the ward inside the Chronosphere, but you should be able to place it on the outside. And it's just easy damage for a full channel. Death Ward, Gyrocopter as well, Flat Cannon, cooldown, easy setup. Team Empire go with the not-so-popular Crystal Maiden. We see it here and there, and it can work out very well. And Freezing Field, definitely a spell that becomes a lot easier to get off when the Chronosphere is going. However, Lion, they pick up probably tier 1, number 1 numero uno support. It's the Lion. Two disables. If you get the Aether Lens, it becomes a lot easier to stun the Faceless Void or hex them during that Chronosphere as well. The Finger to nuke someone. Beastmaster Lion combo is just so powerful at the moment. Roll someone up, take them down really low, even just like straight away when Lion hits level 6, he can rotate to that off lane where Beastmaster's got his level 6, roar up the carry, finger him, and then he's dead. Pretty simple stuff. In terms of Team Empire now, looks like it's probably going to be a Faceless Void off lane. I highly doubt it'll be a safe lane Faceless Void, and I don't think Invoke will be going anywhere other than the mid lane. So Team Empire got to pick up their carry and their ball position here. I guess it's going to be, I don't know, Crystal Maiden. She can find the levels. I'd like to see them maybe pick up like a fairly self-sufficient carry hero. And they're going to pick up the Clinks. There we go. Just because Crystal Maiden can then roam off, go off into the jungle, maybe go ganking with the second support, whichever one that might be. And then the carry can sort of get solo farm as well, and Clinks is definitely one of those heroes. Combos well with the Crystal Maiden as well. The Frostbite locks him down so Clinks can guarantee get off his strafe, and all those fiery arrows can hit in the back of whichever target that would be. I should also mention, actually, Crystal Maiden, I assume, does very well against the Enchantress and Beastmaster. Against the Enchantress, you got the Frostbite against the creeps you might grab. She does head off to that off lane, or just throughout the entire game, actually. But Beastmaster, his boar, I would assume, gets locked down for the full creep duration as well. The Frostbite. So, pretty smart pickup here, and the mana aura. What's it called? Arcane aura. Makes sense. I assume that obviously always helps out your team, especially, well, Invoker's normally does okay in the mid lane for regen, but make sure Faceless Void is topped up, always has the mana to time walk away. So, fourth pick now for Power Rangers. They're looking at their mid and carry hero, most likely. I mean, they could run the Beastmaster mid. They wanted to, maybe Enchantress off lane, but I think it'll be a position for Enchantress. That's a lot more common. But I like that they've left the draft pretty open in that respect. Really nice. They've only got 30 seconds reserve time now. They're going to go with the Sven. I probably should have guessed this. The armor, fantastic for running, you know, run away from the Clinks, the Warcry, running away from Crystal Maidens, Nibi, or running into the fight. Allow for an easier stun on a target of Power Rangers choosing. I think another hero that once he's been given some space is fairly self-sufficient in lane. The Max Cleave, just push the lane out. Yes, this gives the offlaner experience, but I think Faceless Void generally gets experience in the offlane anyway, just because he's so... he can sustain himself with the time walk. So you just push out the wave, force them to last hit onto tower, and then you can go farm up the jungle if need be. Or give the lane to Lion. Something like that. Bans. Wind Ranger get banned out by Team Empire. I'm kind of surprised by this. I don't think Wind Ranger is that strong at the moment. That's okay. And Wind Ranger get... not Wind Ranger. The Winter Wyvern banned out by PR. And okay. Enigma picked up for Team Empire now. They got some pretty big team fight. Like, arguably Enigma and Faceless Void are fairly anti-synergistic in a way. But if you think about it, it actually makes a lot of sense. But Broodmother for PR. What do they have to deal with this? Not that much. The surprise Broodmother 5th pick. I guess they were not expecting them Beastmaster mid, but that's where it's going to go, I would imagine. Or is it a mid-Brood? Might be a bit mid-Broodmother up against Invoker. That's pretty strong as well. So I look forward to that. But here we are. So it's just a one game series between PR and Empire and part of this WePlay Season 3 tournament. I think it should be a pretty close one, to be honest. And I'm going to quickly run through who's playing what on what side. We've got Big Nun playing the Enchantress. This is PR on the Radiant side. Goddamn on the Sven. Cheshire Cat on the Broodmother. Arise playing the Beastmaster. And finally J4. On the Lion. Over on Team Empire's side, we got King R on the Crystal Maiden, Afterlife playing the Faceless Void, Biposhka on the Enigma, Scandal playing the Invoker, and finally, I don't know, that's probably not his name, but Starlene 666. I don't know which of the players that will actually be. Hopefully his pause doesn't last too long. Personally, I think in terms of lineups, I don't know. Right, so PR, they've got the Lion Beastmaster combo, which is really freaking scary, and they've also got a Broodmother, who I'm not really sure they've got too much to deal with it. Yes, maybe Crystal Maiden with the Crystal Nova. Invoker's Tornado, if that's what he ends up going. And I guess Enigma's Midnight Pulse will be fairly effective, but against the Broodmother, just breaking down the trees can be really helpful with that. But apart from that, they're pretty limited. But meanwhile, on the other side, Empire's team fight is kind of ridiculous. With the Chronosphere, you've got the Crystal Maiden ultimate, which deals ridiculous damage. The Black Hole as well. So we'll have to wait and see. So I think if Empire can execute it, maybe go for... I guess they got the potential to push fairly early with the Enigma. You can go for an early mech. The Clinks as well, and I'm guessing it's probably going to be Exalt build from Invoker. With the Forge Spirits, might do fairly well, and then if PR try and defend, they got to watch out for the Chronosphere, makes defending a little bit hard, but here we go! We are underway. I just want to see what items... It could be like a position 4 Beastmaster, because Arise... I don't know, what are they starting off with? Could well be. Enchantress. No, it's going to be an offlane Beastmaster, I guess. With a position 4 Enchantress, just by what items they've picked up. This should definitely be very interesting. Lion's got a couple of sentry wards there to block off any... to catch out any observer wards, but Afterlife on the Faceless Void. He doesn't have any on him, so he's just going to sit here. He might have a little peek at the bottom rune. Meanwhile, Broodmother, the Broodmama, is setting up her little trap in this top lane. I'm sure of the Empire, they've seen this. They're more than aware of what she's capable of. Do they have any detection for her? One sentry on the Enigma. And... three sentries. Holy mother of God. Three sentries on the Crystal Maiden. I'm going to be keeping an eye on this top rune at the moment. I think bottom rune is definitely secured for PR, but whether Broodmother... okay, Broodmother's like, okay, there's three sentries on Crystal Maiden. There's no way I'm sticking around here. They see her with the Observer Ward. Actually, no, that's her own Observer Ward even. No, it is Emperor's Observer Ward, so they're going to see that. So in the bottom lane, it is going to be Beastmaster picking up that Bounty Rune and Invoker getting the Bounty Rune for Empire. So equal start. So it is going to be the Arise Beastmaster in the mid lane. I think Beastmaster does okay against the Invoker. He's got 67 base damage, which is kind of, is actually really good. Start off with the Stout Shield as well, should get a fairly early bottle. And he's also got the Boar as well to help harass the Invoker. The deny comes out from Invoker. Meanwhile, I guess they'll be looking to get fairly aggressive early on in this top lane if they can, but Broodmother's just one of those heroes that's just so hard to zone out. You can expend so much and she still gets all the full experience, but they're gonna go now, try and throw out what right click damage they can, but she was just on the edge with that sentry ward. They couldn't quite catch her out, and now she's gonna regen up with the Tango. I like how they've placed the sentry ward. It's in the tree line, so it's gonna be very hard for the Broodmother to deward, even with the two sentries. She's automatically fighting up against an extra sentry as well. It's because the Crystal Maiden bought out so many of those. And our Faceless Void is going to try and stop this little bit of farm going on for the Lion. He's now up to level 2. Still, Broodmother fairly happy. I'm just going to have to always keep looking at this top lane. They have potential. Meanwhile, Enchantress smoking up two Central Conquerors. Could this be a chance to go? They're going to move on very fast forward. They should be able to get this, especially with the slow. One stun. Second stun is going to come out in time, but the regen is coming through with the quads, but there's going to be enough damage. Beastmaster with the Boar and the Wild Axes is going to be getting the first blood. One center will be a casualty, but more than worth it for the first blood before the 2 minute mark as well. Well played there from PR, and Enchantress even denied, well, tries to deny the centaur. It has done its work, getting the first blood and giving Arise a little bit of an advantage here. Already boots with bottle, 400 gold as well. Gonna be a nice advantage over the Invoker. Nice little stun there, trying to get the last hit as well. Gonna go both the way of Sven. Already getting the two levels in the Great Cleave and just the one in the Stormhammer. This has just become so common. You get the brown boots and you go straight into the Helm of the Dominator. Get a creep, start stacking up these ancient camps. Like from like 5 minutes. And then when you hit level 6, you can go farm them up for maybe level 7 or level 8 with this God Strength. Really, really boosts up your farm. And I guess that's kind of why Sven is so strong. Much like, I guess, in the past, I guess like SF and stuff, just his ability to farm so quickly, get ahead of the enemy carry as fast as possible, and then you could just push and take the advantage from there and hopefully win the game. At least that's usually the plan anyway. It's pesky, pesky tornado coming in from the Enchantress. Two tornadoes going after Invoker. Invoker gets really low there. Arise a little bit scared of diving too far. I guess the upside for Empire at the moment is... oh, I'm going to look towards the bottom lane at the moment. God damn, he had to use that Warcry to get himself away. And now with only one extra Tango. Okay, another one's going to come in as well. For Sven, but... oh, okay, in the top lane, we do see the dive coming in, but Cheshire Cat goes falling to the tower, but there's still a bunch of spiderlings attacking King R now on the Crystal Maiden. They're going to go outside of the webs as Crystal Maiden is going to eat her way through, and even being a Crystal Maiden should have enough move speed to get away from these spiderlings. However, as an offlaner, the Broodmother is probably more than happy to trade her life for the Klinks, especially if she got the kill first, so that's experience going her way. 3-for-1 now. Once again, Faceless Void is going to time walk that damage that Lion puts out with the Earth Spike. Not even gonna bother with the mana drain. Sven's gonna be careful here. He's on half HP. I mean, it's still a solid 430, and I guess he can buy the lifesteal now. Actually, he's just gonna go with the Helm of the Iron Will. Plus 3 HP regen. It's probably equivalent, and the extra armor is really good. And Enchantress once again looking to rotate. Maybe try and find this Enigma, but Enigma is being helped out by the Crystal Maiden, so this could be the turnaround on the Enchantress. They already have a level of Malefice, but Crystal Maiden deciding to Frostbite one of the creeps. Only one of the creeps. There we go. Bench goes down, just in case there's someone else sticking around. Any Observer was, but the smoke? Okay, Enigma plus the Crystal Maiden, and looking to maybe get aggressive onto Cheshire Cat if they can. Do they have another sentry is the question. There's two more sentries, plus two dusts on the Crystal Maiden. If they can find him, then he's surely going to go down. They use the dust, eclipse him, but he's just got the extra... Well, he's still pretty slow. They're going to be able to fight him. He's trying to duke it out at the moment, but this is where the Enigma comes in handy with that Midnight Pulse, and Cheshire Cat will go down for the second time. Crystal Maiden getting up two kills now. Both kills on Empire's side going the way of the Crystal Maiden, and she's up to level 5 already. He's actually got some... decent farm to be able to buy these, buy this detection. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Yeah, good job getting that kill now. 3-2, 6 minutes in. But Brumilda's got that level 6, opting to not go for the Insatiable Hunger for now, and even has her own Dust of Appearance, because Klinks is an invisibility here as well. Top rune. Looks like there might be a fight, but Arise is going to be forced back. Is he going to be forced to use that Primal Roar as 3 heroes get on top of him? He's going to try and cast it, but it keeps getting cancelled by the Cold Snap and the Frostbite, and Priestmaster bottling up through this. He's going to survive! They thought they had him! He's going to survive! He's going to juke it, but no! He doesn't! The Crystal Nova from long range is going to be able to get them the kill. As they're going to, bottom lane, Afterlife, going to go down. Sven with the stun, no time walk for you. Looks like that was a movement in from the Crystal, not the Crystal Maiden, the Enchantress to get that enchant, the slow. Boots up on Lion. Playing the position 5 Lion. He's not going to have the best time. Blink Dagger that you'd sometimes like to see. Maybe Enchantress can help out with the wards to try and boost them up with that. Sven already with the Helm of the Dominator. Where's his creep? Ah, there's his creep. It's the ranged creep already heading off. And whoa, this is a quad stack already. Sven's going to have a field day when he can get to that with his ultimate. Max Cleave, yeah, the 1-4-1 build. Pretty good work. Meanwhile, in the top lane, they're chasing after the Crystal Maiden. They need to put down some more webs. She's in a lot of trouble as Beastmaster. Does he even need to commit the Roar? Not a chance. But Crystal Maiden survived there as Broodmama nabs the kill with the spawn spiderlings. And they're going to chase up the Klinks. Remember, she does have the detection, which she's going to use straight away. And in comes Beastmaster. He does use the Roar just to secure it. But once again, I don't think they needed it. That's a double kill going away of the Broodmother. And they can start pushing down this top lane. Enchantress tried to get some experience in the mid lane. Looks like she was harassed out. And she has stolen a Forge Spirit. That's always nice to have. So two kills in the top lane should lead to a tower kill. And, yeah, I'd say it's going pretty well for PR at the moment, but their mid lane is going to get pressured in. Early rotation from Enigma with the Sol Ring. Doesn't quite have mana for the Black Hole, now does. It's probably the, I guess a Black Hole into a Sunstrike is the best way of killing off the Enchantress at this stage of the game. And it's perfectly okay to use up that Black Hole this early on and on just one hero. Obviously, you'd like to get more if possible. It's okay, Lion with an Invis Rune. He does have mana for just one Disable, though. I guess he could throw out the Mana Drain during the Disable. Meanwhile, bottom lane, that's the Sunstrike coupled up with the Chronosphere. Goddamn, he's dead. And that's a big carry for Empire, as this was Sven on the carry roll. I forget that's another combination which Empire have up their sleeve if they want to pick someone off. Once again, solo Chronosphere perfectly fine early on in this game. The cooldown is really not too bad. And mid tower. Not quite in deny range. And there's this Hawk well positioned. Currently invisible. To help them take down this tower. At least give them vision. In case any big rotations comes in. But now the army. The zoo coming in. Enchantress gets the tower kill. Extra gold meanwhile top lane. Oh, Cheshire Cat gets another kill. On that squishy Crystal Maiden. And this... this late pickup of the Brewmother, the fifth pick from PR, it's really put a spanner in the works for Empire. This top lane really being controlled by her now. A pesky, pesky spider. This Master's got that role, so if they can get eyes on this Klinx, they don't have at the moment. In fact, this is four Empire heroes now down this bottom lane. The Klinx sees goddamn at the moment, but there's no way you can pick them off at this stage. They need a black hole. 100%. And okay, oh, Sven, yeah, he's gonna run himself away with the Warcry. Klinx, did he? Oh, he just stole a creep with the Death Pact, it seems. Meanwhile, Brewmother doing Brewmother things. Lots of spiders attacking the tower, and I think Empire have just decided to give up on her at the moment. It's once again Klinx scouting out for his team as the three other heroes from his team are just gonna push down this bottom lane. And if the raiding get too aggressive here, Klinx, the extra man, might surprise him with Sven. He's going to throw out the stun. It's onto the Invokers, just forcing him back for now as the Malefice comes through. Stunning him up. Beastmaster does have the roar. The Hex lands onto Klinx. They're going to throw out the roar. They don't have the vision just yet. The stun coming through. Crystal Maiden, remember, she doesn't have her ultimate yet. So that's going to be the Klinx going down. Can they find any more? The Impetus throwing through. Crystal Maiden solo. And goddamn, just going to use that ultimate. The Karai clicks as Big Num gets the second kill. But Sven did most of the work there, or at least half of it, with that God's Strength, and two dead from Empire, and the rest of the team are just going to TP out of there, get themselves to safety, and that was a four heroes in PR. Cheshire Cat gets that top lane, that T2 tower, now gone. Speaking of towers, that... Okay, Chronosphere was committed on the bottom lane. There was just fights happening everywhere, and this is only 11 minutes into the game. Top five net worth owned by four of the PR heroes. That extra tower gold really helping out, plus the extra kills. This could be a pretty short game if things continue this way. Oh my goodness. They are so far ahead in net worth. That is pretty ridiculous. As they're about to lose another tower on the side of Empire. Okay, this smoke. They've got to be able to get a big kill out of this. Crystal Maiden still doesn't have that level 6 though. She needs to find that if she's going to be able to combo up the Freezing Field with the Enigma. They're going to look for the wraparound on the Broodmother. But meanwhile, bottom tower, nah, does go down. Beastmaster gets that one. They're going to be able to try and find the Broodmother. This should be a fairly easy kill with the Sunstrike coming down, plus the Meteor. Yeah, they stop the push for now. They're going to try and clear it up a lot, these Spiderlings, but look at them, they're just too fast, moving through the webs, and they're going to get regened up as well. Klinx trying to find a kill somewhere. Man, this Brood, 7.2k net worth is PR. They smoke up. Klinx could break this, and this is the Lion Beastmaster combo I was talking about. In fact, there's no finger, but at least there's extra lockdown with the Enchantress as well. Dragon Lance complete should be easy enough. You gotta be careful though. It's nighttime, so vision is restricted. Spiders continue to push this top lane. Klinx, is he going to be able to spot them? No, he's just hiding out for now. And Sven's going to take this big old stack. And meanwhile, there's going to be a fight in the mid lane. They roar up on the Enigma. The Sunstrike's going to come through. Does hit on a rise, but I think some of that damage was split elsewhere as Lion gets the Hex onto Crystal Maiden as Invoker goes down. That must be a bunch of Impetus targets, but we're going to see Crystal Maiden let it go. Is she going to find the first kill, the second kill? Enchantress just too tanky, too much heals at the moment. I say tanky is very much a pseudo tankiness, but the level 4 Enchantress will going to make it hard. They even commit the Chronosphere. They're trying to throw right clicks out. They're slowed by so much. I think they're going to finally be able to get this kill. They do. Klinx with the right click. Doesn't even use the Searing Arrows, but it's a 2-for-2 trade-off, so... To be honest, it probably favors Empire here. I'll, okay. Fight recap doesn't lead to much. Let's bring another back alive. Time to put some more pressure onto this top lane if she can. It's gonna farm up the jungle now as Klinx. Doesn't have any detection for the Broodmother. Broodmother. Doesn't have any detection for the Klinx, so kind of a lose-lose situation here. And maybe Roshan is the next objective for PR. Beastmaster, level 2 Necrobook, very nearly level 3, and this is 14 minutes into the game. If you look at this graph, 10k pretty much net worth advantage favoring Power Rangers. just over 4.5k in XP, and with Sven to throw out the damage, going for this the early damage. Sven going for that armlet over the BKB, sort of like a BKB blink into something like a Crystallis. Oh, probably an AC would be the normal thing, but Roshan goes down and Sven's going to pick up the Aegis, so he's going to be, you know, you can pick him off once, he's going to come right back at you, swing his great sword. I guess the question is, how do Empire stay in this game, being so far behind in net worth this early on? Invoker does have the Midas to help him catch up. Enigma now goes for the, he went for the blink over the mechanism. I guess they want to try and take some big team fights. His Broodmother, they ping her out. They won't know where she is because there's a Kliggs. The Sentry Ward goes down. They got the dust. Are they going to commit any more to this? They even go for the black hole. Sunstrike's going to give. Actually, Enigma takes the kill there. They commit a lot of spells there. The big spell. Big black hole, just to kill off that big old spider. It's probably worth it, to be honest. She's worth a lot of gold. How much was it in the end? 595 gold. So, yeah. Oh, that's fine. And it kind of... I mean, if PR obviously going to stick us forward and push another lane, but at least Empire now don't have to worry about that top lane. It's going to be a little bit of a slower siege coming in. You got to remember, because PR are stuck around quite a lot, their levels are... they're actually alright, to be honest. Like we saw in the XP graph, they're ahead of Empires. Can be some of the downside, as Klinks... They didn't know he's here. Are they guessing? Klinks only got that one level in Strafe, so 4 seconds of damage against Enchantress might not be enough. And that's a level 3 Necro now. And that means Klinks has to be very careful when running around next to Beastmaster. An early gem might not be a bad idea. But I guess 3 dusts will do it. As Klinks nabs that arcane rune. But yeah, PR's pressure seems to have baited it a little bit. They're just invading the jungle, maybe looking for a pickoff before they truly go high ground. Yes. So that's God Strength, the blink on forward from Sven, but he gets Frostbited up here. He's going to have to use that Warcry to try and get himself out of there, but actually, he's not scared. He's just going to lay his damage onto the tower as the fortification comes through. Got to be careful with the armlet toggling. He does still have the Aegis, though, so he's going to get the tower. As Klinks might think about wrapping around from behind. Still, Sven, he did just use that stun, the blink on forward. Actually, face forward, he does have blink. He jumps on forward, but he can't get his damage out as he gets stunned up as that for now. The tornado flying through, but doesn't really hurt on anyone as the Enigma is already dead. And now the right clicks onto Klinks. He needs to get out of there. The right clicks onto Klinks, but the tower, the melee barracks is going to be the next objective. They take the tower, they get the melee barracks as a pause comes out. Oh, no. This is unfortunate. As the Crystal Maiden DC is using a lot of trouble here. Enchantress, still plenty of mana to throw out that impetus. Faces Void, he's already used his ultimate. There's no Black Hole after using it to pick off the Broodmother. Line did go down, though. So it will be a 5v4 fight. Sven is low, but he's got that extra life. Completely missed the blink pickup on Faces Void, but the Chronosphere was ineffective. Okay, Crystal Maiden reconnected into this game. Even Evoker's got a blink dagger as well. So lots of movement. Okay, the time walk away. I don't think Kingar's getting out this one. One more right click should do it. It's going to be going the way of the Broodmother now. The stun onto Klinks. Remember, Sven's still pretty low, but Aegis still there. Okay, it's finally going to be popped as the Midnight Pulse goes down as he turns off the armlet. But they get what they were looking for. One set of racks. Can Empire find anything more? Face Void jumps on forward using that time dilation. But Sven, using that the war cry, he's got pretty good movement speed even through the time dilation. Look at that slow. It is ridiculous. Mini stun onto the Enigma. And Invoker's going to be forced back because of Spiderlings. And Lion back up and alive now. Just going to push out this mid lane. Still more stacks for this Sven to farm up. But he's not even the most farmed on his team. That is that title goes the way of the Broodmother, who's, if she wants it, has got the Necro 3s. What would Empire do for an Echo Slam right now? I guess Empire, it's just like they've got their wombo combo. They've got the blink black hole into the chronosphere with the invoker spells and the crystal maiden ulti, the freezing field. I think that's all they have to go off of. We have to hope for a good high ground defense, hope for PR to maybe have a little bit of a misstep, maybe clump up a little bit too far. You get that 3-4-5 man chronosphere. I honestly think that's the only way Empire get back into this game at this stage, because that is what their lineup is best at. Ooh, mother already thinking about laying her webs elsewhere. There's no need to put them on top lane. Top lane's already been pushed in. She can start pressuring the bottom lane. Let her team deal with the mid lane, and there's a good chance they could take two sets of racks simultaneously. And that is... I saw a blink. There's a blink on the Beastmaster. Interesting build. Klink's going for the Maelstrom. So extra attack speed. And I guess the thing is... It gives you quite a bit of fairly like good early damage. And oh no, Klink's gets spotted out here. They have the detection. Is that a gem? Or I don't even know how they see him there. But yeah, gem on the Beastmaster. The Roar committed, but that's not a very long cooldown. Let's get rid of the Klink's for 40 seconds. Might as well. Beastmaster, that was Beastmaster with the gem, and still goddamn smoked up. Got that blink ready to jump on someone if he sees anyone. Looks like the entirety of PR. They're just going to group up now, and he's put another web down. But everyone that's a little bit out of mana here does, however, have the Soaring. Man, look at this Echo Slam opportunity. It's sending the minions forward. There's the Midnight Pulse, which is doing some damage. It's causing them to split up a little bit as well. But the Spiderlings plus the Necro units doing some decent damage to tower. Now down to 300 hit points. And with this crit wave coming up, none of the heroes have even need to put themselves in danger. They're actually just going to back the hell out of there. Maybe a little bit worried about what the Faceless Void is. In fact, they see him now. Tower does not go down. Left on 184 HP. It looks like they might just be playing it safe here, like going, okay, if we lose a team fight, like if we lose 4 or 5 heroes, we're going to give Empire a lot of gold. So they're going to wait for the ages, wait for Roshan to respawn, which is possibly up in the next minute and a half, probably a little bit longer. As okay, Empire, they smoke up outside of the base. They know if they can win a team fight now, maybe take Roshan, they could get themselves back into this game. Enigma leading the lines with the blink dagger. Got the dust if need be against the Broodmother. But obviously if they spend this smoke just to catch the Broodmother out, but she's going to move down to the left-hand side. She's going to spin her web and just get out of there as Afterlife jumps on forward with that time walk. Not going to be able to find anyone, and smoke completely wasted by Empire due to Broodmother just being a pain in the ass. Up on that high ground, invisible. Now, the Spiderlings chasing up the King R. It's like, just get me out of here. It's a nightmare. But yeah, I think the Maelstrom, it gives you that extra bit of like magic damage, which is great against the... great against the Enchantress and the Sven with the Warcry. And there's the Chronosphere catching out the Sven. The Sunstrike's going to come down as well, but the right clicks for Big Dumb, they're just too much. Sven survives through all of this with the armlet toggle still alive. And now J4 just has to be careful. The Roar onto the Klinks with the Necro unit should be enough. There's the Crystal Maiden ulti surrounding. It's going to hit on a few people here. They're going to throw out the right clicks, but GG. Just going to be called by Empire. They've had enough. Disconnect from the Klinks and okay. Game over. That ends very quickly. He's had enough. He gets picked off. There seems to be nothing that he can do. He's just going to call a very quick GG. A good black hole there from Maposhka, but that's game over. Hopefully the game will actually end now. Okay, that was a bit of a strange end. Strange ending there, folks, but... what can I say? I guess Klink's just had enough. And what was possibly, or what people thought, at least I generally thought, was going to be a fairly close-ish game, turned out to be very much a dominant performance from Power Rangers. With the Enchantress going 6-1, Beastmaster 4-1. Yes, the Broodmother died a couple of times, but she forced so many rotations to her to kill her. It doesn't really matter in the end. Just managed to push and got such an early advantage. The game was over in 22 minutes. Empire, I quite liked... this was the issue, though. They were all based around team fighting. The Klinks was based useless because he couldn't get any pick-offs. And then, you know, they try to get their combo right on Empire. They just never seem to be able to. But that's all, folks. I believe this was just one game, so that's over fairly quickly, fairly easy. As Powering just take the victory in WePlay League Season 3. I hope you enjoyed this cast. I'm Zambrella. You can follow me on Twitter and Twitch at Zambrella101. Any feedback would be appreciated, what you did like, what you didn't like. I'm looking to get better, and hopefully you'll get to see a lot more of me. But until then, have a good time.